Hi, this is Ken Blystone, and I want to welcome you to blystoneclass.org, my classroom in the internet cloud. When you visit blystoneclass.org, you will have access, free access, to our learning tools. Our learning tools cover a variety of topics. This presentation will focus in on our slope comparison tool. Let's go ahead and get right into it. Our slope comparison tool looks like this. You grab the little green dot and you pull it down, and you can place it here, and I'm going to take the red dot and place it at the top of the airplane tail. We hide the image, and that's the slope of the tail. Let's go ahead and try another picture. Here's a fun one. This is a roller coaster, and we put the green dot down here. We take the red dot and put it up at the top of the railing, and let's go ahead and hide this image. And you can see that this is a very steep slope on a roller coaster. That's what makes them so fun. And this is the rise, and this is the run. The horizontal is the run, the rise is the vertical. Okay, let's go ahead and look at another image. This is another airplane tail, but notice that when we put the green one down here, the slope extends from the tail with a paint job. And so we put the red dot up here, let's hide the image, and on this one we'll go ahead and count. All right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 on the rise, and the run is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we have a rise of 8 over a run of 7. So this slope is in excess of the number 1. Let's try another image. This one, oh, look at this one. We have a bicycle here. We could put the green dot underneath the bicycle seat. We can move the line down to the pedal cranks, or we can do the bar that's between the seat and the handlebars. Notice that this is a very shallow slope, but we could change that to a very steep slope if we want to measure this bar. So bikes have an interesting geometric design, and that can be explored in this particular system. Now, we're going to look at this snowy mountainside. Let's go ahead and get our slope set. So we take the green dot and put it over here. We take our red dot and put it up at the top of the hill. And let's go ahead now and discover what the slope of this mountainside is. We'll hide the image. And what we need to do is get our rise, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And actually, it's a little bit more than 5. It's probably about 5 1/4. And then we need to get the X, which is the run, which is actually 18. It goes all the way across the coordinate grid system. So we have a run of 18 and a rise of 5 1/4. So what is the slope of this line? How do you do that? Well, the easiest way to do it is to just get a calculator. Grab a calculator real quickly. Well, you can use the calculator that's in your computer. And you put in the 5.25, we already know the numbers, and you divide that by the run, which is 18, so let's plug in 18. Now we have our rise over our run, and that ends up being 0.2916 repeating. So if you round it off, you have about a 0.29. That's the slope of this mountainside right here. That's the slope of that line, about a 0.29. Now let's check that against another program. Now we're going to bring up the program called GeoGebra. Now this program is freely available. Just go to GeoGebra.com and you can download a version for yourself. And what's really cool is that you can move this coordinate grid system around. You can place it wherever you want. And then you can go up and use a tool to import that same graphic that we were looking at. So you go up here and you say, I want to insert an image. You let the computer know where the bottom left corner of that picture is, which picture you want. We want the snowy slope. So we'll open that, and there it is. It imports it for us. Now we can pick that picture up with our mouse and move it anywhere we want to on that coordinate grid system. And notice where I'm going to place it. I'm going to put it down here so that the slope exits at 2 on the y-axis. I'm doing that on purpose. Now, we can take that picture and we can move it to the background, which puts the coordinate grid system in front, which is really cool. And then let's go ahead now and get the slope equation entered so we can see if that matches our calculation that we made earlier with the calculator. Y equals 0.29x plus 2. That's our intercept. Our y-intercept is going to be at 2. and there's our line. Now, if we click on the line, we can change the properties of the line. Let's go ahead and make the line stand out. We'll make the line blue, and we'll make it real thick so we can see it easily. So we'll crank that up to about a 7, and there's our blue slope line on top of the snowy mountainside. Now, do you notice anything, class? The run. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The rise. 1, 2. This is a different coordinate grid sheet than the other one. So let's check it and make sure it still works. We have to make sure that this is still going to give us a 0.29. So if we take the rise, 2, and we divide it by 7, the run, sure enough, it comes out at 0.2857. A little bit more precision, but very close to 0.29. So this shows you how different coordinate grid systems are going to give you very similar answers. It's just that with GeoGebra, it has a little more precision. So you can use GeoGebra or you can use splicestoneclass.org to get started with our slope comparison tool. We encourage you to come and use our slope comparison tool. You can try the other pictures that we didn't have time for in this presentation. And you can use any of our other tools that you see listed on the screen. We invite you to also visit GeoGebra.com and get the GeoGebra program, which you can download, again, freely available. It's a wonderful teaching tool, wonderful program for doing algebra and doing geometry. Well, thanks for visiting my classroom in the internet cloud, blystoneclass.org, and I hope to see you back in my classroom real soon. Bye-bye.